हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, सो अगेन वेलकम बैक इन अनदर टॉपिक ऑफ कॉनिक सेक्शन। लास्ट टाइम इन कॉनिक सेक्शन आई डिस्कस्ड अबाउट एलिप्स, दिस टाइम आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द हाइपरबोला, अगेन इन द फॉर्म ऑफ द लोकस ऑफ ए पॉइंट। सो इफ आई वॉन्ट टू डिफाइन हाइपरबोला, देन देर विल बी यू कैन डिफाइन लाइक दिस, ए हाइपरबोला कैन बी डिफाइंड एज द लोकस ऑफ ए पॉइंट विच मूव्स इन ए प्लेन इन सच ए वे सो दैट द डिफरेंस ऑफ द डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम द टू फिक्स पॉइंट रिमेन्स सेम और कॉन्स्टेंट। अगेन सपोज दिस ग्रीन बोर्ड विल बी माई प्लेन एंड ए पॉइंट विल बी मूविंग इन सच ए वे सो दैट इट्स डिस्टेंस, द डिफरेंस ऑफ इट्स डिस्टेंस इन द केस ऑफ एलिप्स, इफ यू रिमेंबर इन द केस ऑफ एलिप्स वेन द पॉइंट मूव्स इट्स सम विल बी रिमेन्स कॉन्स्टेंट जस्ट अपोजिट टू दैट। एज यू नो दैट द मैथमेटिकल इक्वेशन ऑफ एलिप्स विल बी एक्स स्क्वायर अपॉन ए स्क्वायर प्लस वाई स्क्वायर अपॉन बी स्क्वायर इक्वल्स टू वन, एंड फॉर हाइपरबोला दैट विल बी एक्स स्क्वायर अपॉन ए स्क्वायर माइनस वाई स्क्वायर अपॉन बी स्क्वायर इक्वल्स टू वन। सो दैट इज जस्ट अपोजिट ऑफ द एलिप्स। इफ आई राइट डाउन इट्स डेफिनेशन देन इट कैन बी लाइक दिस, अ हाइपरबोला इज डिफाइंड एज the locus of a point moving in a plane in such a way so that the difference of its distance distance from two fixed points remains same or constant. Each of the two fixed points are known as focus. So you wonder that how two focuses are there in case of hyperbola. So if you remember in mathematics when we studied hyperbola, the hyperbola we will get in the form of twins. Actually what we will suppose that actually two cones just opposite to each other will be cut by a plane, so we will get two hyperbolas. So one focus will be for the this hyperbola which will be in the left side, and the other focus will be for the hyperbola that will be on the right side. So those two fixed points are focuses. So again if we read the definition, they are saying hyperbola is defined as the locus of a point moving in a plane in such a way so that the difference of its distance from two fixed point remains same or constant. So if in this case, suppose in this figure, as already I have drawn in rough in very simple freehand sketch, there will be this hyperbola and this F1 and F2 will be focus 1 and focus 2, and this point will be the vertex, that is the first point on this hyperbola, and this is V2, that is the second vertex of the second hyperbola. So according to our definition, if this V1 will be one of the point on the curve, then according to our definition, this V1 F2, so the distance of V1 from F2 minus V1 F1 must be equals to a constant. This is the definition. And as you know that the distance of the first vertices from the first focus will be equals to the distance of the second vertices from the second focus. So it means V1 F1 will be equals to V2 F2. If in equation 1 I will replace the V1 F1 by V2 F2, then the equation 1 will be V1 F2 minus V2 F2 will be equals to constant. And this V1 F2 minus V2 F2, that is equals to this value V1 V2. and this v1 v2 is known as transverse axis. So in this particular method, what we are going to do, we are going to justify all those points which we got in the plane that will be in such a way so that this difference will always remain equals to v1 v2. With the same logic you can justify for the point v2, and same way other points I can mark also with the help of the same method. Again, the name of the method is known as arc of circle method, or pupil will also call that intersecting arc method. So this arc of circle method will be for the ellipse as well as for the hyperbola. In next class, in next two classes, I will draw ellipse by arc of circle method as well as hyperbola by arc of circle method. So this is the basic concept how this curve will be generated by this equation. Yes, okay. So I hope you understand the concept. What is hyperbola? Thank you. Thank you very much.